How often do you cross a bridge and think to yourself, this is magnificent? Hi everyone, my name is Ken. Welcome to This House. Today we are exploring the Eads Bridge, an early engineering marvel that continues to impress us to this day. Eads Bridge was built by the Illinois and St. Louis Bridge Company with the Keystone Bridge Company, founded in 1865 by Andrew Carnegie, serving as subcontractor for steel superstructure erection. Andrew Carnegie led the expansion of the American steel industry in the late 19th century and became one of the richest Americans in history. Because of the increased reach of newly constructed railroads, river shipping trade had declined in importance compared to the earlier years. Chicago was fast gaining as the center of commerce in the West. The bridge was conceived as a solution for St. Louis to regain eminence by connecting railroad and vehicle transportation across the river. Although he had no prior experience in bridge building, James Eads was chosen as chief engineer for the bridge. In an attempt to secure their future, steamboat interests successfully lobbied to place restrictions on bridge construction, requiring spans and heights previously unheard of. This was ostensibly to maintain sufficient operating room for steamboats beneath the bridge's base for the then foreseeable future. The unproclaimed purpose was to require a bridge so grand and lofty that it was impossible to erect according to conventional building techniques. The steamboat parties planned to prevent any structure from being built, in order to ensure continued dependence on river traffic to sustain commerce in the region. Such a bridge required a radical design solution. The Mississippi River's strong current was almost 12.5 feet per second, and the builders had to battle ice floes in the winter. The ribbed arch had been a known construction technique for centuries. The triple-span tubular metallic arch construction was supported by two shore abutments and two mid-river piers. Four pairs of arches per span, upper and lower, were set 8 feet apart, supporting an upper deck for vehicular traffic and a lower deck for rail traffic. Construction involved varied and confusing design elements and pressures. State and federal charters precluded suspension or drawbridges or wooden construction. There were constraints on span size and the height above the waterline. The location required reconciling differences in heights, from the low Illinois floodplain of the east bank of the Mississippi River to the high Missouri cliff on the west bank. The bedrock could only be reached by deep drilling, as it was 125 feet below water level on the Illinois side and 85 feet below on the Missouri side. These pressures resulted in a bridge noted as innovative for precision and accuracy of construction and quality control. This was the first use of structural alloy steel in a major building construction through use of cast chromium steel components. The completed bridge also relied on significant and unknown amounts of wrought iron. Eads argued that the great compressive strength of steel was ideal for use in the upright arch design. His decision resulted from a curious combination of chance and necessity due to the insufficient strength of alternative material choices. The particular physical difficulties of the site stimulated interesting solutions to construction problems. The deep caissons used for pier and abutment construction signaled a new chapter in civil engineering. Piers were sunk almost 100 feet below the river surface. Unable to construct falsework to erect arches because they would obstruct river traffic, Eads engineers devised a cantilevered rigging system to close the arches. The Eads Bridge was recognized as an innovative and exciting achievement. Eads secured 47 patents during his lifetime, many of which were taken out for parts of the bridge's structure and devices for its construction. On June 14, 1874, John Robinson led a test elephant on a stroll across the new Eads Bridge to prove that it was safe. A big crowd cheered as the elephant crossed the bridge towards the Illinois side. Popular belief held that elephants had instincts that would make them avoid setting foot on unsafe structures. President Ulysses S. Grant dedicated the bridge on July 4, 1874, and General William T. Sherman drove the gold spike, completing the construction. After completion, 14 locomotives crossed the bridge to prove its stability. The bridge stood strong, allowing millions of people to travel across it over the century to come. In 2012, the BSDA Metro started the Eads Bridge Rehabilitation Project to extend the life of the bridge to at least the year 2091. The restorations including replacing 1.2 million pounds of struts, bracing, and other support steel dating to the 1880s, removing all paint and corrosion from the superstructure, repainting the superstructure with a rust-inhibiting coating, repairing damaged structure, rebuilding concrete supports, restoring the brick archways, and upgrading the Metrolinx rails. The total cost was $48 million, with $27 million coming from the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act of 2009. While expected to start in 2009, work did not begin until 2012 due to labor disputes and higher than expected cost estimates. Workers completed the project in 2016. Thank you all for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I would also like to extend a special thank you to our members whose names you can see on screen right now. Please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I'll see you next time on This House.